With any inflammation in the lung tissue, the amount of neutrophils greatly increase, and the activated neutrophils in the area of inflammation begin to secrete proteolytic enzymes, like neutrophil elastase, that destroy elastin fibers and thereby cause severe damage to alveoli. Just recall that the walls of alveoli are composed of connective tissue, primarily of collagen and elastin, and also the basal membrane that separates the gas inside the alveoli from the blood in the blood vessel is also composed of collagen and elastin. So when neutrophils release elastase in the lung tissue, it's like a fire meets gasoline. This proteolytic enzyme rapidly destroys elastin fibers, thereby it causes severe damage to the walls of alveoli and also to the basal membrane, and this condition called emphysema. Also, one of the major risk factors of emphysema is cigarette smoking, because smoking provokes additional inflammation in the lung tissue. To control this very aggressive enzyme in liver tissue, hepatocytes in endoplasmic reticulum produce specific protein called alpha-1 antitrypsin. This protein is delivered to all tissues, but the major site is the lung tissue. This protein inhibits proteolytic enzymes like trypsin and elastase, and by this it controls inflammation and prevents damage to alveoli. What we also have to know is that alpha-1 antitrypsin is encoded by SERPINA1 gene that is located on long arm of chromosome 14, and normal version of that gene called M allele. So M allele results in normal production of alpha-1 antitrypsin protein. But we know that mutations can alter nucleotide sequence of a particular gene, and by this they create other versions of this gene. And recall that the versions of gene called alleles, and different alleles results in different production of alpha-1 antitrypsin. So a part of the M allele, there are S allele that encodes moderately low antitrypsin production, Z allele that encodes very low antitrypsin production, and null allele that encodes no antitrypsin production at all. As we know, person has one allele from each parent, so healthy individual has two M alleles, and this results in totally normal antitrypsin production, and by the way, it's the most common combination. People with MS and MZ variants have slightly decreased antitrypsin production. SS and SZ combinations results in low antitrypsin production. Important that there is still enough amount of antitrypsin to protect lung tissue, but this category of patients are at high risk of lung injury, especially with smoking. And now, very high yield concept. People who have ZZ variant are at very high risk of lung injury and also liver injury. With lung injury, everything is simple. ZZ variant causes very low production of alpha-1 antitrypsin that cannot sufficiently inhibit activity of proteolytic enzymes, and this results in alveolar damage. With liver damage, it's not that simple. The concept is that ZZ variant produces not only a small amount of antitrypsin proteins, these proteins also have slightly different structure that makes some of them prone to polymerization. And this polymerization occurs right after the protein is synthesized in endoplasmic reticulum. And in polymerized state, this protein cannot be secreted. And because of that, ZZ variant, also called unsecreted variant of alpha-1 antitrypsin protein. And the specific feature is that these polymerized antitrypsin proteins are strong chemotactic agents for neutrophils that comes into liver tissue and begin to rapidly produce proteolytic enzymes that cause inflammation in the liver tissue that results in severe liver damage. And what we have to understand is that because alpha-1 antitrypsin production begins right after birth, this progressive accumulation of polymers causes severe liver inflammatory damage since neonatal period. And because of that, this condition called neonatal hepatitis. And where is inflammation, there is fibrosis that with time progresses to cirrhosis, and cirrhosis markedly increases the risk of hepatocellular carcinoma. So patients with ZZ allele can have cirrhosis or hepatocellular carcinoma in a very young age. Another possibility is null phenotype. It's the most rare variant that results in no antitrypsin protein production at all. Thereby, patients who have this variant are in huge risk of the most severe lung injury, but because there is no production of antitrypsin protein at all, there is no risk of polymerization and thereby no possibility of liver injury. So liver injury is a unique feature of ZZ variant. So there are a few characteristic features of alpha-1 antitrypsin deficiency. First of all, because alpha-1 antitrypsin deficiency causes emphysema, which is a form of chronic obstructive pulmonary disease, patients usually present with typical COPD symptoms as chronic shortness of breath and productive cough. and very important that they have these symptoms in a relatively young age. For example, smokers present in their 30s, whereas non-smokers present in their 40s. And when emphysema develops in a 40-year-old person without any smoking history, it's a quite a suspicious clinical situation, and in such case we always have to keep in mind the possibility that this person maybe has very low antitrypsin production. The characteristic feature of alpha-1 antitrypsin deficiency is pan-acinar, also called pan-lobular emphysema. Basically, it's a destruction of predominantly of the lower lung lobes in the basal regions of the lung. Because, for example, smoking-induced emphysema involves predominantly upper lobes and called centriacinar, also called centrilobular, so it helps in differential diagnosis. Also, keep in mind that with ZZ allele, patients can have hepatitis, cirrhosis, or even hepatocellular carcinoma in a very young age.